What is up, you happy hustlers out there? Kerry Jack here, and I am so excited because it's day 7, baby! Passionate hobbies. This is where we actually have some fun. I mean, not saying that you haven't had fun previously, but this is where we infuse more fun. And I'm kicking things off with a quote, which is, fun is a non-negotiable. And that is by yours truly. So, let's enjoy some fun hobbies and let's do them regularly because this one is essential and I think very much overlooked, especially now in this, you know, modern day society where everyone's just forcing themselves to be more and more productive, but not really enjoying that journey along the way. And enjoying passionate hobbies is something that really can just catalyze your happiness to the next level. So let me review. It's essential. If you're not having fun, then you're probably gonna burn out. So whether it's oil painting or swing dancing or playing pickup basketball or swimming or knitting, whatever, you have to give yourself permission to do the things that you love, and you have to do it regularly. Now I find, at minimum, myself personally, twice a week is a necessary frequency for me to feel balanced in my work. So I focus on doing things that I love to do, like Krav Maga, for instance, you know, Israeli survival system. I train Krav Maga at least, you know, twice a week. I'll also, you know, throw in some fishing, maybe once a week if I'm feeling froggy. I like to do soccer. You know, I played soccer my whole life, so I do pickup soccer on Sundays. You know, with the guys, it's always fun to get together. And that is just something that takes me out of my, you know, my workflow or any drama at the house or, you know, in the business. And I focus on, okay, this ball, this goal, my team, how I can help them win. And it's beautiful. And that's what happens when we do hobbies that we're passionate about. We forget about all the other BS. And that's why you have to infuse more of them. I'm also taking private dance lessons with my partner, Steph. I mean, it's a blast. And not to mention it helps, you know, improve our cognitive function, but it also, you know, with memory recall, and studies show it actually helps decrease the risk of dementia as well. So there's a ton of value in doing hobbies and increasing that creativity. It's not just, you know, a waste of time as one may think. It's actually really important. And it's very important that you do it regularly, like actually choosing the activity and doing it regularly. So here's what I'm asking you right now. Decide, what are your top three hobbies? Three, like the three things that you love to do. What are they? Think about it. Okay, I want you to write these down, but just think right now. What are the three hobbies that you really love to do? What is it? Painting? Is it dancing? Is it martial art? Is it, you know, being outdoors and going hiking? Whatever it is, figure it out right now. Then I want you to actually decide what days, based on your current schedule, are best for you to do these hobbies, okay? And don't just breeze over this. This is essential. I mean, we're talking about the journey, 10 days to becoming a happy hustler. And passionate hobbies is a cornerstone in being happy. So decide what days are best for you. Is it Monday, Wednesday, Friday? Is it, you know, Saturday, Monday? Is it, you know, whatever. Decide what days are best for you. And I want you to actually schedule these things into your calendar. Like, make them a point that you're actually going to do them. It's not enough to just say, well, I'll get around to it. No, I know every Monday or every Sunday at 9 a.m. I got a soccer game with the guys. And I gotta, you know, drive and be ready to play and have my water bottle ready and have my orange slices or whatever. You know, it's just important that we say it's 9 a.m. Sundays. That's a game day, right? Or Krav Maga is usually on Thursdays. Okay, I'll fish hopefully sometime around Tuesday or Monday. Just depends on my given week. But I want you to set this up. Every Sunday, you can decide what's best for that week, but it is important to schedule it. And another thing I want to mention is actually doing things that you're curious about, not just like, hey, I love, you know, playing basketball. That's great, but I want you to do more than just play basketball. I want you to do something that you're curious about and change it up every 3 to 6 months. This way, you won't get bored doing your passionate hobbies. You'll actually create new skills and in the process, meet new people and expand your horizons. So figure out what you may be curious about. You know, think, oh, I've wanted to try kiteboarding, or, oh man, I wish I could get my pilot license. You know, that's a passionate hobby. It's also, you know, gonna cost you, but it's okay because you're gonna have to step aside from that money-making mentality right now in this module, and you want to focus on what those passionate hobbies are to you and then scheduling them into your day and then realizing that it might cost you to do them. You know, I have to pay my Krav Maga instructor. That's okay because he's an expert and I'm learning a skill that I love and that I know will protect me and my family in the future. So that's okay, but it's okay that value exchange is there. So figure out something that you're actually, you know, excited about doing and that value exchange is there for you. Now, when you get clear on when you're going to do these new hobbies, and like I said, 3 to 6 months, you should switch it up. You should do a new hobby and you should schedule something, you know, new. Then you can really have that schedule where you know, hey, this is an actual, like, you know, priority for me. Passionate hobbies is a priority. I'm not just going to postpone it if I don't feel like it. It's like, no, I committed to dance class and I'm going to go. Even though I'm tripping all over myself and looking like a fool, it's okay. I'm committed because that's how we get better at things. You have to commit and you have to practice, right? So figure out what that is for you and schedule it into your everyday, you know, routine. Treat those hobbies on your calendar with the same priority as you would work. And that's, you know, just something that's going to be a little unusual at first because you might want to just let that slide, but in reality, you have to give it that same importance or else you're probably just gonna, you know, let yourself slide and say, oh, this week, you know, I'm not gonna go play soccer. I'd rather, you know, watch TV at home. No, that's not how it works. If you wanna be a happy hustler, which you do, you gotta do the passion hobbies. And why would you not? Because they're fun. So that's really what I wanna talk about in this module. You cannot claim to be too busy to enjoy fun activities. That is what life is about. So focus on scheduling enjoyable hobbies into your everyday life, hopefully at least a couple times a week. I recommend having three hobbies and doing one of them at least, let's say, three times a week. So you do three hobbies three times a week. That's 3 days you're doing something, you know, three of those hobbies. It's not that big of a commitment. Maybe it's 3 hours of your week. Not that big a commitment. So choose what you love to do, schedule it, and do it. That's the breakdown for this module. Pretty simple. Do fun and you'll have more fun in your life. Ta-da! I know. Mind blown, right? Mind blown. All right. Hope you got some value from this one. I'll see you in the next one. Peace and love.